Is it possible to prevent metabolic syndrome, also referred to as syndrome X, in postmenopausal women using menopausal hormone therapy? Well, as you probably know, metabolic syndrome includes a constellation, a whole bunch of different health issues all at the same time that really put women at serious risk. Hyperlipidemia, that means low HDL and high LDL cholesterol. Prediabetes or insulin resistance, indicated by high fasting blood glucose and hyperinsulinemia. High blood pressure, visceral fat, and obesity, especially around the waist or the belly. I ran across a review article a couple of days ago entitled Effect of Menopausal Hormone Therapy on Components of the Metabolic Syndrome. It was published in Therapeutic Advances in Cardiovascular Disease in about 2017. Well, it looked at several randomized controlled trials of menopausal hormone therapy to find out whether hormone replacement in menopause might have a positive impact on reducing the symptoms and the risks associated with metabolic syndrome. I'm Steve Goldring from simplehormones.com. I help patients and healthcare practitioners with easy-to-understand patient education resources, especially about hormone optimization. Well, the article that I'm reviewing in this video is all about hormones, especially estrogen and progesterone used in women after menopause. The question is, do optimal hormones really help postmenopausal women have less metabolic syndrome? Well, if you know of a book, a study, a website, or some other patient education resource that you'd like to share, drop a comment in the space below and let me know about it. I'll put it on my list for a possible future review. Well, in looking at this review article, we may want to keep a few caveats in mind. The first is that the trials that are reviewed in the article are almost all older. They're large-scale trials that mainly involved conjugated equine estrogens, often along with medroxyprogesterone. Those were the specific hormone replacement given to women after menopause. Number two, a few of those trials included estradiol, which has been shown to have several advantages over conjugated equine estrogens. Natural or micronized progesterone has similarly been shown to be far superior to medroxyprogesterone in a bunch of studies over the past 20 years. The third caveat is that one of the authors disclosed some research support from Pfizer. I guess we'll have to take that at face value. Even though the specific hormones used aren't the ones that are preferred in general now, I believe this review can still give us some insight into the impact of hormone replacement on metabolic syndrome after menopause. Well, this article looked at five major clinical trials, the PEPI trial from 1995, the HERS trial from 2003, the Women's Health Initiative, or WHI, from 2004, the Danish study, or DOPS, 2003, and the SMART-1 in 2009. It was a little odd that Duavay, a Pfizer drug combination of basodoxifene and conjugated estrogens, is included in this review, but whatever. Other trials that are mentioned in the study or that I bring into the discussion include the Nurses' Health study in 92, the EPAT study, the KEEPS or Chrono study, and the ELITE study from 2016. This paper kind of evaluates the impact of menopausal hormone therapy on four specific areas that are associated with metabolic syndrome or syndrome X. The first is adiposity or fat, especially visceral fat and menopause weight gain. The second is insulin resistance or prediabetes along with type 2 diabetes. The third is hyperlipidemia and dyslipidemia. That has to do with your LDL and HDL cholesterol levels. And the fourth area of metabolic syndrome is hypertension. The consensus among the clinical trials was that menopausal hormones, quote, prevented the increase in abdominal fat after menopause compared with placebo. Pretty simple. Patients in the Nurses' Health study on estrogen with or without a progestin had about a 20% decreased risk of diabetes when compared to patients not given hormones after they adjusted for age and BMI. Women given hormones in the PEPI trial had lower fasting insulin levels. There was a sub-study of the WHI, the Women's Health Initiative, which showed a significant decrease in fasting glucose in women who took hormones. A meta-analysis of 107 randomized controlled trials reported that women with diabetes assigned to hormones had a reduction of insulin resistance. It was about 35.8% compared with placebo or no treatment. Pretty substantial. All the major MHT trials using conjugated equine estrogens, HERS, PEPI, WHI, confirmed that hormones produced a reduction in LDL, increase in HDL, and increase in triglycerides compared to placebo. That same meta-analysis showed overall hormones increased HDL by 5%, decreasing LDL by 11%. In a subgroup analysis, these effects were more pronounced with oral agents compared with, say, transdermal estradiol, and they were dose-dependent. Overall, oral agents increased triglyceride levels by about 6%, while transdermal estradiol really has no effect on lipids. Other studies that haven't been mentioned here have shown that oral estradiol has shown some dramatic positive effects on dyslipidemia, and transdermal estradiol really doesn't have that much effect on lipids. There's not really much of a consensus about the effects of hormones and high blood pressure in menopause. Some of the studies mentioned in this review showed that estradiol has a modest blood pressure lowering effect. Some showed that conjugated estrogens reduce blood pressure, but transdermal estradiol and oral esterified estrogens didn't. The EPAT trial used 1 milligram of oral estradiol, and it really showed no difference in blood pressure over 2 years between placebo or estradiol. Well, the article concludes that the impact of menopausal hormone therapy on blood pressure is complicated, maybe because of individual variability. If we look at the overall conclusions of the review article, the authors kind of reached several. One is that estrogen deficiency promotes metabolic dysfunction, predisposing women to obesity. Number two is that numerous studies show hormone replacement has beneficial properties on metabolic syndrome in postmenopausal women. And number three, the transdermal estradiol and micronized progesterone are really the preferred forms of hormones, preferred over conjugated estrogens and medroxyprogesterone as menopausal hormone therapies. I've included a link to this review article, it's fairly short, as well as some of the trials that it referenced. You can read those for yourself and come to your own conclusions. It's obvious that menopausal hormone therapy does make a difference in metabolic syndrome. If this review has been helpful, click the like button. Subscribe to my channel to get notified whenever I post a new review. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll talk again soon.